This is the River Hawk Report. Today, a look back at the UMass All Hockey season gone by. A season that, despite 19 wins, ended too early. A talk with UMass All Hockey coach Blaze McDonald. We present that conversation in two parts. Today, part one. Part two will be presented next week. How are we to look at this past season? Do we look and say it's a disappointment we didn't go to the NCAA tournament? Do we look and say it's a success, back-to-back winning seasons for the first time in a while? Nearly 20 wins, maybe one win away from the NCAA tournament.
Boy, I've been struggling with that assessment myself. There's a lot of me that is very pleased with what we did. You know, you can certainly point to a lot of real positive things, a lot of successes that we had this season, and, you know, we can lump last season in there as well. And there's a lot of frustrating times this season. I'm angered by, you know, our lack of good fortune, you know, whether it be bad officiating on goals called back, whether it be hitting a post at a key time, or BC getting a lucky bounce off a stanchion. You know, there's just a lot of things that I feel about the season, you know, and I guess the biggest part is that, you know, we won 19 games. We had the best team defense in the league. Our attendance in the Songa Center was phenomenal. Our record at home was 11-5-1. You know, we had a couple guys make the Hockey East All-Star team. Ben Holmstrom, the top forward. Carter Hutnick, the top goaltender. And we finished, you look at the three teams that made the NCAA tournament, our record against those three teams out of Hockey East was 4 wins, 2 losses, and 3 ties. That's pretty darn good. So you sit here wondering, well, why aren't we playing? And that's really disappointing. It's frustrating, and I'm still struggling with it.
It almost sounds like we're an enigma.
It's hard to explain some years, you know. Like, you know, you look at the Patriots a couple years ago. They go undefeated in a winning touchdown that a guy couldn't catch in a million years, they catch, you know. Or you can go back years where, you know, Bill Buckner all of a sudden, it's sports, man. Things go your way. Scott Norwood hit, you know, wide right for the Buffalo Bills. I mean, those things happen, you know, but you've got to stay with it. You've got to be realistic in looking at what we've done. I mean, we finished in third place, tied for third place. That's pretty darn good, you know. It's the best finish in 14 years. And I just think the types of kids we're getting in here now, the senior class, they are really just such a credit to the university, to the community, you know, and I feel so bad for them. I think they just deserve better, but, you know, it just didn't fall our way this year.
As far as Hockey East teams, I think we had the second most wins. I look at the NCAA tournament and see that there were 3 or 4 teams in the tournament we had more wins than.
We just failed to really capitalize on opportunities. You know, I look back at so many games that we just failed to capitalize on, where October 30th against Boston University, we're playing great. 3-2 lead going into the third period, and all of a sudden, uncharacteristically, we give up an incredibly soft goal to all of a sudden tie the game with 16 minutes left. We didn't recover from that, and then we go into overtime, take a penalty, and give up another soft goal. Like, then we win the next night at BU, right? And, play Princeton, and their goalie makes 47 saves, play a phenomenal game against Northeastern at the Dartmouth tournament for a championship, and don't get it done there. Lose 2-1. Play well enough to win the Omaha, right from the beginning of the year, the Omaha tournament. We have a 3-1 lead during that game, you know, 2-1 lead after one, and we just, you know, we found ways not to get it done. And I look at, you know, if you use a baseball analogy, boy, we wasted a year of really good pitching, you know, and just didn't get enough run support. You know, I thought both of our goaltenders, and certainly Carter down the stretch, played exceptional and put us in a position to win all the time, but we just couldn't get them enough run support.
As you look at this season, are the games that, for you, this is the highlight, and as well, this is the most frustrating?
Well, I really think the Vermont game was the most frustrating, you know, because it's the Vermont and Maine, obviously, but Vermont, we dominated, and, you know, their season's over. Like, we outshoot them, I think it was 38-17, but we have a power play in overtime, and we just can't. Those are your go-to guys, your playmaking guys, and we just couldn't get plays done. Couldn't make plays. We couldn't end that game. We couldn't get home ice by winning that game right within our grasp. We have less than 5 minutes to play to get, and we're going to the Garden, going to the NCAAs. We're accomplishing some of our significant goals in less than 5 minutes. All we have to do is just manage 3 more shifts each, and we panic and overplay, and they end up scoring a goal, a lucky goal. You know, once again, there's the bad break, and he goes off the shaft of a defenseman, no screen in front, and just redirects precisely between the goaltender's legs. So that's what angers me. It's, you know, just to look at those two instances and say, what the heck, you know, it's right there for us. Missed two open nets against Providence down there. We ended up tying that game 2-2. So, you know, you can always, I think, reflect back and find some frustrating moments for sure. But I certainly thought we played well against Boston College this year. And, you know, we had a big win up at Maine, you know, the second. You know, we had some big wins when we had to down the stretch. And we had guys step up that, you know, when there was an injury, guys were able to step up and replace them with some good quality minutes. So there's no question we had some really positive moments to the season. But, you know, it was a season of just barely not doing enough to get us to the NCAA tournament.
Talk about highlights for a moment. And I don't know if there's one moment, one game, one moment within a game that stands out most in your mind, whether it's a Mike Shue overtime goal at Northeastern in a game that had been a wild night.
Yeah, I don't know. I really don't think there is one moment, you know. I really liked beating Boston College here at home. That was great for our fans, you know, and that type of thing. And that was really something that was special. You know, winning, historically, we've really, really struggled winning up at Maine, you know, and the fact that we were able to win two games up there this year, I think that'll give us some good traction moving forward. And those were big wins. But other than that, you know, I think our expectations were pretty darn high and we, you know, we weren't surprised. I liked how we came out against Providence and Vermont in our last two series at home here and thumped them big time on Friday night. You know, those were must wins. You know, one was a trap game, the other one was a game of you know, they're a desperate team and we're trying to get home ice, and I really liked how we played in those games as well. So there was definitely some positives in there for sure, but once again, I think we expected us to ourselves to play like that.
When one looks at the journey, and we look at this senior class in the 4 years that they've been here, they end with back-to-back winning seasons. When they started, they weren't sure that it'd even be a program the following year. So certainly the growth during the time that that group of seniors was here, they have indeed taken dramatic steps in a journey that continues as they graduate and continues into the future.
Yeah, you know, and that's really what we do here. We're not just, you know, we're not professional coaches that it just roll out the wins and losses and winning percentage. You know, we run a program here. It's much different than running a team. And a program is bringing in the right people that fit and can excel in your environment. You know, when we brought in this senior class, and, you know, they struggled their first year getting wins, but played very, very well, got a lot of experience, but really did a great job in the community outreach, did a wonderful job on campus, did a great job in the classroom. They were everything that, you know, I would want one of my sons to grow up to be like. You know, this senior class was phenomenal in that regard. I think very respectful of their opportunity that the university provided them. And then as their career went on, they went through a most potentially devastating time where our program was in, you know, in flux, and they stuck by our program. We did lose a couple of kids, but they stuck by our program, and they were rewarded with tremendous commitment from Chancellor Meehan and the administration and the community with our crowds and that type of thing. And it was nice for their last 2 years. They were able to give back to the community. I mean, they had 19 wins in the last 2 years here at the Tsongas Center and had a 19-11-2 record at home. So that's a great thing, and, you know, they, you know, really ignited a lot of pride in our program and the university last year by making it to the hockey's finals and really a disputed goal away from making the NCAA tournament. And this year there was some really positive moments, and 19 wins given this day of parity in college hockey, 19 wins is pretty darn good. You know, that was like the old standard of probably 24 wins. So they certainly made me very proud as a head coach, and I'm sure will continue to make this university proud as they continue their journey.
You would talked about changing the culture around this program. It began to change immediately, and one sees it's come all the way. When you look at this group of seniors who academically were terrific, who in the community were terrific, who just genuinely are fine young gentlemen.
They really are, you know, and it's an ongoing challenge, you know, in this environment to be able to bring in the right types of kids. And early on when we were here to really change that, I thought, you know, the culture of this program needed to be changed significantly. 180, if you will. I think we've done that. And now I think you will attract like people. So when we bring recruits in, we know if they fit in or they don't fit in, because our guys will filter that out and let us know, and or it just runs its natural route. As a result of that, you know, we've got Ben Holmstrom's younger brother, Josh, is coming next year. You know, we've got former players here, their sons are coming here. You know, we're able to attract people that are close, you know, family members and stuff that want to come and continue their education and hockey careers here. So that speaks volumes of how they feel about the program and what they've been able to get from the program, and it's good to see that. So I think we'll continue on the right path.